Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today in this video we are going to understand about BC zone choppers. The BC zone chopper is basically a transistorized chopper. A power transistor is used as a switch. It requires continuous base drive to keep it on. It gets turned off when the base drive is removed. So for quick turn off, a limited negative base drive is given. The negative base drive helps in removing the storage charge quickly, thus helping in the quick turn off, turn on and off. No extra commutation is needed. So now we also provide a freewheeling diode for use and to circuit while freewheeling load current in the circuit is provided in the turn off period. So basically this theory will be explaining the step up and step down choppers of transistor based voltage commutations. So now we move on to the experiment through the skids which are provided by Tesca. So this is our trainer kit of BC zone chopper, also known as step down and step up transistor choppers. So the order code for this trainer kit is 46564. Now I will explain the different circuitry which are printed on this circuit board, which are also interconnected in this circuit. So this is the basic power supply which gives plus 12 volt and minus 12 volt power supply to the different transistor sections. And this is the step up chopper section in which there is a 40 millihenry coil which are provided in the choke, and this is the transistor based switching which this transistor used as a chopper to switch the DC current, and there are the diodes which are used, the diodes and capacitor are used to protection of this bulb load which is a 15 volt 230 volt lamp. Now we move on to the frequency generator circuit. So this is the frequency generator circuit in which there is a triangular wave producing IC which is also provided to the op amp IC which is a 741 IC which further gives the square wave, and this is the basic transistor based square wave switching circuit. Now this is the step down chopper circuit. Also in the frequency generator circuit we have frequency adjustment port here, and this is the duty cycle control which controls the duty cycle of the on and off sections of the transistors. Now this is a step down chopper in which the 12 volt DC motor is operated with this step down chopper. So step down chopper as we know basically used in the applications of motor controls. This is the transistor here to which are work on the rapidly frequencies, and this is the snubber circuit to protect the motor for all the surges and negative and positive high voltages. And this is the power on off switch to turn and on and off this switch. We are also provide user manual in which the experiments are given while working with this kit. You have experiment to perform the step up and step down choppers, and these are the patch codes which are included in this accessories. So now we will start with the experiment of first experiment, which is to study the step down transistorized DC chopper. So we will follow this procedure of given in the manual. For this we will move on to the trainer kit, and we will first power on this trainer kit by this on and off switch. So as I power on, we can see the gel light is glowing, so that means the circuit is in power on. First check the potentiometer knobs and make them at the minimum position or the zero position. Now we will check the waveforms at different locations through the CRO first, which is the function generator circuit. So we will connect this black probe to the negative F point and the red probe of the CRO will be connected at point A. Here we will find the triangular wave. You can see the triangular wave at the CRO here. So as I increase or decrease the frequency here, the frequency increases and decreases from the kit. You can see, and also the duty cycle also changes and varies the waveforms. So now we will observe the waveform at point B. So this is the basic DC signal which do not shows any waves. Now we will check the waveform at point C. So which this is the output from the comparator circuit. This is the square waveform. So these are all waveform which are given in the manual also. So in the manual we can also observe and verify the waveforms which are getting at the kit. So these are the different waveforms at point A and point B and point C. These are the square waveform, DC signal and the triangular waveform. Now we move on to our next step which is given in the procedure. For this, switch off the supply at the off position. First we will switch off the supply of the strainer gate, remove the CRO probes, and now we will connect the DC motor which will be works as a step down chopper. So for this we will connect point S on the kit to the point T which is the motor's terminal, and we will connect point D with the point U. So we have provided supply to this DC step down chopper. So after providing supply we will power on this kit, and we can observe the DC motor is rotating here. Now as I increase the duty cycle, the speed of this motor or the chopping of the this chopper circuit increases, and motor runs at the smooth. So as I increase the frequency you will see the speed of this motor first increases then decreases. Now we will observe the waveform at this motor load. For this we will connect the CRO at point Z and F. So this is the Z and this will be the F, and now we will auto tune the CRO and slowly increase the duty cycle. At some point we will find the square waves or the distorted waves. So after setting the duty cycle and frequency range, one can find the square wave which is little distorted here. As I press the single button on the CRO which will be stops the waveform of output. So here we can see the distorted square wave. So due to the inductive load, as we know the motor is an inductive load, ET and EIL waveform which is the output waveforms of this DC choppers or step down chopper will be not accurately rectangular in the shape, which will be slightly distorted, which we can see at the CRO. So this is our experiment. So the output waveform will be slightly distorted, but as we increase the duty cycle the waveform will also increase and decreases. So that's how we use the step down chopper to operating a DC motor. Now we move on to our next experiment, which is to study the step up or boost transistor DC chopper. For this, we will make the step-up chopper as the power circuit, which is also shown in the manual. And for this, we will connect P point to Q point and D point to R point. And we will keep the output below the VCO of the transistor. So for this, we will move on to the circuit and we will connect this P point to Q point and this D point will be connected with the R. So the controlling of this circuit will be remains with this duty cycle control and frequency adjuster. With this function generator circuit, we will control the step up chopper and we will observe the waveforms at chopper's output at this X point. So we will on the power circuit here, and for this we will make sure the CRO probe at the 10x 1 by 10x probe, which is also properly described in the manual here. So we can see the output waveforms of this chopper. So as I increase the duty cycle, we can also see the bulb load glowing from these holes at the kit. The bulb is very low power, so the glowing of this bulb shall not be able clearly to visible on this video, but you can visible with your neck dies while working with this kit. So as I increase or increase the bulb is glowing. Now I will decrease the duty cycle and increase the frequency. You will see the bulb has turned off or glowing is intensity is going decreases. Now as I decrease the frequency and increase the duty cycle, you will see the waveforms are changing at the T on and T off cycles. So the waveforms has high voltage input due to the step up chopper. So the CRO probe should be 1 by 10 probe, 1 rest to 10, and these are the output waveforms which will be provided at the load and at the X point. In the manual also we have given the waveforms. So these are the duty cycle waveforms and output waveforms similarly as we are getting on the CRO. So that's how we perform the step up and step down chopper or the BC zone chopper through this kit. So you can see how we experiment on this kit. So while performing the experiment, you can easily take the theories references on this manual which are given in this manual. So if you find any difficulty with this manual also, you can easily while performing this experiments on this DC BC zone chopper kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.